Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a minute. My name is Tommy James, in case you're new here. And if you're not new, thank you so much for coming back to my channel today. It has been a minute. In fact, this is the first video in this year, and I am so very sorry, guys. First of all, do not mind my background in this video. I was cutting my lace for frontals, and I thought yesterday, and I thought, why not just make a quick tutorial for my YouTube family, right? So in this video, I'll be making frontal. I'll be showing you how to save a whole lot of money, more than 70%, by buying your own Swiss lace and cutting it yourself instead of buying just frontal or closure from the market, right? So if that sounds like something you want to watch, if that sounds like something you want to learn, please keep on watching. Thank you. So for these, I usually cut about 9 inches vertically, and maybe about 14 inches horizontally, right? I cut it out from the Swiss lace. This is not the actual measurement that I want to use, just to give it enough space. So now I am measuring 6 inches with my tape rule, because usually this is 13 by 6 frontal. If it is 13 by 4 frontal, you just have to measure, you know, 4 inches vertically, right? So I put the chalk, I put it around the inches that I've measured, right? That is 6 inches. Then I put it down the 6 inches, just to be sure. You want to use a chalk, a candle, or a chalk, a candle preferably, just to make sure that the line does not disappear. Because if you use a chalk, even before you are done, the line might, you know, clean out. So for me, I do 12 inches instead of 13, because most of my wigs are glueless, right? Some people do 11, some people do 13 if it's not glueless. Ensure, what I'm just saying here is, you ensure that you're using a full tape rule, not the one that the measurement is starting from number one, you get. So then I draw a straight line. You don't have to make a perfect straight line, just have an idea of what you're doing. That's from one end to the other end of the 12 inches that I have measured, right? Just to be sure. And if you're doing this, you want to have your measurement close, your tape rule close, because you want to measure from time to time if your measurement is accurate, right? So I am just taking the tape rule again and checking if it is 12 inches, right? So what I do then is try to be sure of where I am measuring to. That is the 6 inches, right? For a first timer, you might want to have something to curve your, you know, line with. But when you get, you know, good at it, you do not need to, you know, have something to curve with. So basically, this is just it. Within 1 minute, you are done. Why this is very cheap or cheaper is, I mean, if I'm checking the amount of this Swiss lace, 1 yard right now, I think it's about 5,000 naira. And from 5,000 naira, trust me, you can take out more than 10 frontals. Yes, because in this, when I was cutting yesterday, I took about 6, I think I did about 6, and I have done 3 before. And from the one that is still remaining, I can still do 2 or 3, and I've done lots of closure, about 3 closure, 6 by 6 closure from the Swiss lace. Now imagine buying for 5,000 naira, or say maybe the price now, because I've bought the bundles for a while now. So say it is now 6,000 naira, and then you can take about 10 frontals away from it. Yeah, I'm just trying to measure again, measure and see if I'm accurate, right? So what I'm saying, say you take about 10 frontals from it. Frontal now, this frontal, I think they sell for 1.2 or 1.5 now. I mean, that's a lot of difference. If you're buying 1.5 and you want to buy 10, that is about 15,000. If you're buying Swiss lace 5,000 or 6,000 and you're taking 10 frontals out of it, that is a lot. That is saving you a lot. be it Swiss lace, be it HD lace, it is just same thing. All right, so this is me just cutting out the excess from the side. You do not want to cut the excess from the top, because that is what shows that the hair you're working on is a new hair, right? So I just take out the excess from the side. I put a little space, you know, remaining, so my ventilators or whoever is ventilating can be able to pin it on the mannequin, right? So basically, honestly, this is just it. Quick, easy, 1 minute, you're done. I just try to line it properly more, give it more definition. I do not sew it. Some people sew around the, you know, edge of the lace, but I do not. I realize that for braid wig making, if we sew it, it is thicker and we cannot flawlessly fill the track of the hair. If you do not know what I mean by filling the track, I have a video that is well detailed on that. I'm going to put it in the description box below so that you can watch and know how to professionally fill the track of your braid wig, right? So this is me just measuring it again and making sure that it is accurate, and honestly, that is just it. Very simple, very quick. You see, this is the ones I've done today, and the Swiss lace is still remaining, and I've done 3 out of it before. It is the best. You cannot be buying Swiss lace frontal one by one in this economy, especially if you're doing in bulk. If you're, you know, you have a factory, you have ventilators, you want to save money a whole lot, right? So basically, that is just it, and you're done. This is another one. I think the lines definitely will be more accurate than each other as you do it, but it really does not matter, really. So for those who do not know, I want to make a quick explanation on the lines you have to cut. This is the vertical line, the straight line. That is how you want to cut vertically when you're cutting it out of the old, you know, Swiss lace. You do not want to cut horizontally like that. You want to cut vertically, because when you want to ventilate, you ventilate vertically like that. So if you're measuring it out of the Swiss lace, ensure that your measurement is vertically like that, straight line like that, you get, so you can have it accurate. And so if you're measuring the 6 inches, you know, so you measure 9 inches out of it, it has to be vertically, that straight line, you get, and then your 12 inches can be horizontal like that. So that is just it, basically. And ensure that you, when you're cutting the edge, this space that has hole, you do not measure it with it. You want to cut it out. The yard of the Swiss lace always come with it. Please cut it out. Do not measure your closures or frontals with that hole. Cut it out. And basically, that is just it for this video. Thank you all for watching. I hope to catch you all in my next video. Thank you.